Hello guys, Mano from Geekception here, and today I'm going to be doing a comparison between the Asus Zenfone 2 4GB RAM version and the Xiaomi Mi Note. Let's begin. And welcome back guys. Basically, this comparison is just going to be doing a very real life test, like the camera, like the performance, how fast it is opening popular apps, and you know, just a general perspective of how the phones are, how they compare to each other, the build quality, and how it feels in the hand. Let's begin. And let's first take a look at the Xiaomi Mi Note. The Xiaomi Mi Note has a 5.7-inch Full HD display with 3GB of RAM and a Snapdragon 81 processor, which means it's really fast, although it's quad-core, but it's really fast as well. No lags there. It's got a 3000 mAh battery, and that's about it for the specs for the Mi Note. Moving on to the Zenfone 2, it's got a 5.5-inch Full HD display as well, paired with 4GB of RAM and an Intel Atom Z3 580, which is pretty nice. Also no hiccups as well. It runs pretty good. And that's about it for the specs of the Asus Zenfone 2. Looking at both of the devices side by side, the Mi Note and the Zenfone 2 are actually pretty slim. I cannot really tell which one is lighter than the other. The Asus Zenfone 2 runs Android 5.0 Lollipop, while the Xiaomi Mi Note is still stuck on Android 4.4.4 KitKat. When it comes to customizations, Xiaomi actually loads the Mi Note with their proprietary Mi UI 6, while Asus loads theirs with the Asus Zen UI, which is also very light as opposed to Mi UI, which is kind of heavy. And the first point of comparison I'll be giving you guys is the display. Both the Xiaomi Mi Note and the Asus Zenfone 2 actually comes with a display calibration, but out of the box, the Xiaomi Mi Note actually looks way better. It has a 95% color gamut, which means that the colors display much more accurately. And taking a look at both of the display side by side, I'll actually give the win to the Xiaomi Mi Note. And now the next comparison is performance. Now the Asus Zenfone 2 has got 4GB of RAM as opposed to the 3GB on the Xiaomi Mi Note, but it's not really that, you know, much of a difference. They both load apps really fast, like really fast, and you know, they're quick to like multitask, so it's not really a problem. When it comes to performance, I'll give them a draw. Both of them are also pretty good. When it comes to cameras, both cameras are actually pretty good. The Mi Note has a very default camera mode, but you can also go swipe to the left, I think, and even get more modes, as opposed to the Zenfone 2, which has like a whole lot of modes. Like, you can actually knock yourself out trying all the modes on the Zenfone 2. But when it comes to quality, I think I'll give the edge to the Mi Note, because the colors look, you know, much more true to life and much more representative of what your eyes actually see. But then that does not mean the Zenfone 2 is bad. It's also very good, but not as good as the Mi Note. When it comes to how the phones feel in your hand, both of them actually feel pretty good for big phones. The 5.7-inch Mi Note, because of that curved back, is actually able to like curve into your hands, and because the Zenfone 2 also has a curved back, it also curves right into your hand, so they both feel comfortable. The only thing is that the Mi Note has glass on the back and aluminium in the middle, so it feels premium, as opposed to the Zenfone 2 that has plastic, which when you look at it, it looks premium, but then when you actually hold it, you're like, oh wow, this is plastic. But apart from that, they both feel very good in the hand. And when it comes to media consumption, both of them have big displays, which means that you get to enjoy whatever media you're consuming. And for similarities, both the Zenfone 2 and the Mi Note have actually got a dual SIM. The only difference is that on the Mi Note, it's dual 4G, so both SIMs can use 4G, as opposed to the Zenfone 2, where only one SIM can use 4G, then the other is 2G. But apart from that, they've both got dual SIM. Another similarity is that they've both got big batteries, 3000 mAh to be precise. And talking about batteries, battery life on the Mi Note is amazing. I easily got 5 hours 30 minutes of screen on time yesterday, but on the Zenfone 2 is actually not so good. I barely able to get 4 hours. I can say 3 hours 30 minutes. So when it comes to battery life, the Mi Note actually beats the Zenfone 2. So now I'm going to go to the pros and cons. And now for the pros and cons for the devices. The Asus Zenfone 2 has got that back button and double tap to wake, which is pretty good, because double tap to wake is really like, when you get used to it, you start double tapping everything. I love that feature. It's also got the back buttons, which make it actually easier to hold because of that curved display. And that's about it for the pros for the Asus Zenfone 2. For the cons, because the screen is not a one glass solution, so when you press it, you can actually feel that it's not, you know, one glass. You can feel multiple glasses, so it doesn't make make it as crisp. Also, the battery life could be definitely better. Not because the battery is not big enough, but because I think it's poorly optimized. So Asus, please, if you're watching this video, do something about that. And when it comes to the Mi Note is actually pretty good. It feels premium when you hold it, you know, it feels really solid in your hand. Pretty nice. And also, the battery life is really good. The display looks amazing. You can easily last a day or even 2 days if you don't really use the Mi Note. Amazing. But one-handed use is actually a problem because of it's so big. You have to always struggle to, you know, get to the top. Even for hands as big as mine, I still struggle to use it. And in conclusion, both of these devices are actually pretty good. I've used both of them. I mean, I'm using the Mi Note now, but I've used the Asus Zenfone 2, and I can tell you that both devices are really good. You know, fast shutter speeds for the camera, ultimate performance, you know, no lags whatsoever. At the end of the day, it depends on you. If you have any questions about this video, about, you know, anything you have about either of these devices, just let me know in the comments below and I shall answer every single comment. Anyways, that has been it for this video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. I shall catch you guys the next time. Don't forget to click that subscribe button so you don't miss future updates. I mean, you don't want to miss future updates, do you? Do you? And also click the like button if you liked it, dislike if you dislike it, and I shall catch you guys next time. Don't forget to be awesome. Bye.